All right, you ready? You got your makeup? Everything all set? All right, here we go. Action! Welcome to American Popular Song Today, changing the way you listen to music. Every week, Teddy and I give you the tools to hear more in the songs you love. It's a special week here at APST because we're bringing you the exciting conclusion of our three-part series, How Songs Tell Their Stories. In part one, we talked about circular songs, songs that tell their story right away and then repeat that story again and again. In part two, we talked about forward songs, songs that tell their story bit by bit over the course of the entire number. But there's another way songs tell their stories, and this third way is my personal favorite. The exciting conclusion of our three-part series begins after the theme song. Hit it! Show, don't tell. Let's dive right in with an example of this third type of song. The tune is called I Hold Your Hand in Mine, and it's by Tom Lehrer. If you don't know it, all the better. This is how the song begins.
I hold your hand in mine, dear. I press it to my lips.
Very lovely, right? It continues.
I take a healthy bite from your dainty fingertips.
Ooh, now we're getting a little risque. I like it.
My joy would be complete, dear, if you were only here. But still I keep your hand as a precious souvenir.
What? The hand is not attached?
The night you died, I cut it off.
Oh my goodness!
I'm sorry now I killed you.
Check, please!
Until they come to get me, I shall hold your hand in mine.
I love that song, and I love the way it works. As the song goes on, the singer provides more and more information. That information broadens our understanding of what he really means when he says, I hold your hand in mine. In the beginning, it sounded romantic. He's holding her hand. Then it sounded a little erotic with those gentle nibbles on the fingertips. Then it sounded kind of necrophilic because the hand had been cut off. Finally, it sounded flat out murderous because he's the one who cut it off after killing her. Because songs like this are all about accumulating information that will change our understanding of a repeated phrase, I call them cumulative songs. You can tell a cumulative song because the repeated phrase will always mean more at the end than it did at the beginning. Let's take another example. One of the greatest songs of all time by one of the greatest songwriters of all time, Don't Think Twice, It's All Right by Bob Dylan.
Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, baby, even you don't know by now.
Maybe we should have mentioned Bob Dylan during our 4th of July episode, linked here and in the description, because Don't Think Twice, It's All Right is just like the Declaration of Independence. Just like Thomas Jefferson's masterpiece, Bob Dylan's masterpiece is a list of grievances articulated by the party leaving the relationship at the moment of the breakup. Every time we hear that repeated phrase,
don't think twice, it's all right.
That repeated phrase accumulates meaning. In the first verse, it's all right means it's all right that this breakup is your fault.
You're the reason I'm traveling on. But don't think twice, it's all right.
We learn more about what it's all right means in the second verse.
We never did too much talking anyway. But don't think twice, it's all right.
So it's all right that it's her fault, and it's all right that they didn't communicate. The next verse tells us what they didn't communicate about. It's all right that we had a big mismatch in expectations.
I give her my heart, but she wanted my soul. But don't think twice, it's all right.
Finally, it's all right also encompasses the time that was invested and ultimately lost.
You just kinda wasted my precious time. But don't think twice, it's all right.
The thing to notice here is not just that we're accumulating information, but that the information we're accumulating is impacting our understanding of the repeated phrase. By the end of the song, the words don't think twice it's all right have accumulated a lot of meaning that they did not have the first time we heard them. And that's pretty special. Nearly all popular songs have a repeated phrase, if not a repeated section. But usually the meaning of that repeated phrase or section doesn't change. Think about The Gambler, which we talked about last time. The repeated phrase is the gambler's famous advice.
You got to know when to hold up. Know when to fold up.
Our understanding of what that phrase means doesn't change from the first time we hear it to the last time we hear it. It stays the same. Contrast that with the phrase, I hold your hand in mine, which means one thing at the beginning of the song, but something quite different by the end. Or don't think twice, it's all right, which continues to expand its meaning as the song goes on. All this is pretty neat. But the coolest thing about cumulative songs is that they are not a world unto themselves. They overlap with the types of songs we talked about before. If you think about it, Don't Think Twice, It's All Right is pretty much a circular song. It lives in that one moment in time and tells the same story again and again. We're breaking up, and that's all right with me. But it's not your run-of-the-mill circular song because it's also cumulative. Think of it like this. Every time you go around the Monopoly board, you collect $200. Similarly, every time you circle through the story in a cumulative circular song, your understanding of the repeated phrase gets a little richer. How about an example of a forward cumulative song? Well, Norwegian Wood, which we talked about last time, is a forward song with a cumulative element. The first time we hear the phrase, "Isn't it good, Norwegian wood?" it's pretty innocuous, referring to the wood paneling in the girl's apartment as decoration. But later, after we've heard the forward-moving story, after the man has been rejected and the woman has left him alone in her apartment, that same phrase becomes more ominous, referring to the wood paneling not as decoration, but as kindling. There are so many other great examples of cumulative songs. The River by Bruce Springsteen.
We go down.
Every time they go down to the river, the innocence it represented has gotten farther away. I Go Back by Kenny Chesney.
Every time I hear that song, I go back, I go back.
Every time he goes back, it's to another song and another memory, so that phrase continues to expand. My Name Is by Eminem.
Hi, my name is what? My name is
Every time he tells us his name, we've learned more about the person who the name represents. Whether the story unfolds in circular or forward fashion, the repeated phrase in those songs continues to accumulate greater meaning as the number progresses. See if you can think of any songs where the meaning of the repeated phrase continues to grow as the song goes on, and put them in the comments. Teddy and I love hearing from you and learning what you're listening to. Now, before we wrap up our three-part series, I want to say just a couple things about these categories we've defined, circular, forward, and cumulative songs. First, I said last time that circular songs answer the question, what? And forward songs answer the question, then what? Cumulative songs answer the question, what do you mean? Because the meaning of the repeated phrase continues to evolve as new information is gathered. Hopefully these questions, what, then what, and what do you mean, will help you identify how songs are telling their stories. But as you're listening to music, no doubt you'll come across songs that don't fit neatly into the categories, or combine them in interesting ways, or defy them entirely. That's fine. The point is not to neatly classify every song into a designated bucket. Art will always find a way to resist bucket-oriented thinking. Rather, the point is to give us a little vocabulary to help us think about the wonderful and diverse ways that songs tell their stories. I think the vocabulary is important because sometimes it's hard to think about ideas, let alone talk about them, if we don't have the words at hand. But now we have some ideas to play with, and some language to go along with them. Take these ideas, run with them, comment about them, share them, and think about them, because that, I promise, will change the way you listen to music, and that's our whole mission here at American Popular Song Today. We'll continue pursuing that mission next week. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. And don't forget to subscribe. Subscribing makes you feel good inside, so don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Subscribing is free and only takes a YouTube account, which is the same thing as a Google account. So if you have a Google account like Gmail, you already have a YouTube account, and all you have to do is click the subscribe button.